Hey guys, how's it going? And welcome to another YouTube video. This is going to be my third episode of my Follow Along Friday series, and today we're going to be doing an upper body workout. So for the sake of convenience, I am going to be using my barbell for some of the exercises. However, I will be inserting a way that you can do them with just a resistance band and a mop, because I know that's what most people have access to these days. And then you're also gonna need a light pair of dumbbells. If you don't have dumbbells like me, you can just use like cartons of milk. I'm gonna use almond milk as my dumbbells. And so let's just get straight into it. Okay guys, so to warm up, I want you to just grab a broomstick or a resistance band. And we're just gonna open up our chest right here. So we're just gonna do like 10 to 15 reps of these, super important. Just open up the chest. Get everything nice and warmed up before we get straight into it. So I'm gonna be inserting clips of like variations you can do with these exercises. I'm using my barbell just for convenience, but all you're gonna need is a broomstick and a resistance band and then like a couple of balls of water or something nice and light, or like dumbbells if you have any, for this workout. So as usual, just have some music in the background for us to work out to. And yeah, just do one more right here, big stretch. Nice. All right guys, let's just get straight into workout. We're gonna be starting with some chest and back. We're gonna be doing supersets, 45 seconds per exercise, back to back with no rest. Okay guys, so our first superset is gonna be barbell rows straight into a flat barbell floor press, okay? We're gonna do 45 seconds each. Since we're gonna be hitting antagonist muscles, the chest and then the back, we're not gonna be resting between these two exercises, and we're gonna do three rounds. Let's just get straight into it. All right guys, so right here with that barbell rows, you wanna make sure your back is nice and flat. You're rowing your barbell or your broomstick all the way to your belly button. Right here, you're really squeezing your back at the top of the lift, and you're keeping your elbows nice and tucked in the whole way. Make sure you're controlling the way down as well. You don't want to just be slamming it back down. You're just going to get some nice time and tension right here. Let's go. 10 more seconds. Keep your core nice and tight. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, just lie down right here. Straight into our barbell floor press. You want to keep the elbows flared out this time. You want to dig your upper back into the mat. Or if you have a bench, that's even better. I don't have a bench, unfortunately. So I'm just going to stick to my mat right here. Looking good, guys. Stay strong. Come on. 15 seconds right here. Keep it going, guys. Keep it going. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys. Standing right back up. No rest into those barbell rows. Let's go. Ooh, I was standing a bit too close to that box over there. Barbell takes up space. I am so grateful to have a big room so I can lift weights. If I was still living in my flat from like last year, I would not be able to do this. So I'm super happy. Let's keep it going, guys. I'm getting pretty warm already. Let's go. 10 more seconds. Keep it going, guys. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, let's lie down. And again, straight into that floor press right here. So again, here on the way down, you want to control it and then explode on the way up. I think chest is one of my favorite muscle groups to train, especially at the gym. At home, it's not that fun because, like, I don't have dumbbells, and I really like training chest with dumbbells. I mean, I'm happy I have the barbell, obviously. I don't want to complain, but it's just not the same feeling as at the gym. And, like, there's just this hype at the gym that you don't have at home. It really isn't the same at all. So keep it going, guys. Almost there. Come on. 3, 2, 1. All right, let's do one more round of these two exercises right here, straight away, no rest.
Let's go. Keep it going, guys. Let's go. 15 seconds left. I really feel this in my lats. You want to make sure you're keeping your torso parallel to the floor as much as you can. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys. Let's lie down one last time. Do that flat barbell floor press. So here with your width, you can kind of play around with it. The closer you go with your grip, the more triceps are going to be involved. And then the wider you go, the shorter the range of motion, but it does become more focused on your chest. So if you're like me and you're a girl that loves to bench, then you know, don't neglect it at home. Keep doing it. Let's go, 10 more seconds, guys. Almost there, then we're gonna move on to our next exercises. In 3, 2, 1, and relax. Whew. Nice one, guys. Well done. Let's just take a minute to rest and we'll go through the next two exercises. Okay, guys, so our next two exercises again for our chest and our back. I have a resistance band just like under my door. So that way when I pull it, it won't move around. If you can find something to loop your resistance band around, that is perfect. So we're gonna be doing seated banded rows, supersetted with just regular push-ups. Now since my chest is pretty written off from yesterday, I might have to go down my knees. I don't know, we'll see, but same thing, guys, 45 seconds each, 3 rounds. Let's just get straight into it. Starting in 3, 2, 1, and let's go, big squeeze. So right here, guys, to retarget those lats, I'm keeping my elbows nice and tucked in. And we're squeezing that band towards my belly button right here. You want to keep a big chest. And at the top of the movement, I want you to think that you have a pencil stuck in between your shoulder blades. And that you really want to just squeeze it there. Keep it going, guys. Over halfway. And again, on the way down, keep it nice and controlled. Let's go, 10 more seconds right here. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's move into those press-ups right here. Push-ups, press-ups, I feel like English people say press-ups, and then American people say push-ups. I don't know. I grew up learning American English, because I used to watch a lot of like cartoons and stuff, but I live in England now, so it's a bit weird. So it's like, I'll say more English words and English slang, but with a more American accent. Pretty funny. Whew, I'm getting tired, guys. Let's go, 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, whoo! That killed me. Straight into those rows again. I might have to go down on my knees, guys, for that next set, because that was hard. That was hard. I felt that in my chest, in my shoulders, in my triceps. Whew. Feels good to be doing back. I've always felt like it's not that it's easy to train back. Like, it can be hard, but I find that in general, like, pulling movements are so much easier than pushing movements. Like, I find it easier to do a row than to do like a press or whatever, you know? Keep it going, guys. Almost there, keep pushing. 10 more seconds. Let's go, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Alright, straight into those press ups again. I'm going on my knees, but I'm still gonna go hard. Let's go. All the way down to these, guys. If you go down on your knees, just make sure your hips don't shoot up, because that's a mistake that I see a lot of people making. Let's Keep it going, guys. Make sure you're bringing that chest down all the way to the floor. Don't give up. Come on. Let's go. 15 seconds. Almost there, guys. Fight for it. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys. One more round of each. Let's go. Straight to those rows. No rest. Let's go. Making the most out of each set. 45 seconds, guys. Every rep counts. I want you to give me quality reps right here. I've recently gotten into like doing a lot of arts in class. It's really funny because everyone's doing such weird hobbies during lockdown. But it's also really refreshing. It's like you're just rediscovering or like discovering parts of yourself that you completely neglected. Like I've neglected my creative side for so long. And last one. Alright guys, last 45 seconds. We're gonna get a break. Push-ups one last time. Let's go. It's hard to talk during these just because they're so much more challenging than the band stuff. Keep it going, guys. Last 10 seconds. Come on. Big push. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Whew. Okay. Nice one, guys. Take a breather, grab some water, and I'm going to show you the last two exercises that we're going to do for chest and back. Okay, guys, so for these next two exercises, they're going to be unilateral, meaning they're going to be using one arm at a time. So this is how it goes for our time. We're going to do left arm, 22 and a half seconds, right arm, 22 and a half seconds for each exercise. Okay, so our first one, we're going to have a resistance band just around us, right here, and you're just going to press with one arm. I don't know if you guys can see better with this arm. Yeah. She's gonna have one arm at a time, pressing forward, just like that. And then we're gonna be doing a single arm plate row or dumbbell row. So we're gonna grab a plate or dumbbell, and we're just gonna row that with one arm at a time. All right, guys, we're gonna be starting in 3, 2, 1. Let's go, one arm right here. It's almost like you're punching forward, but I want you to make sure that you're keeping that shoulder blade retracted and really tight. That way you're engaging the chest more than the shoulders. We're going to do shoulders after this, okay? And let's go on to the other side. Big push. Let's have a side from the front. So I'm really trying to keep my shoulder back right here. We squeeze the chest at the top of the movement each time. Let's go. 10 more seconds right here. Three, 2, 1. All right, guys, we're gonna do a single arm plate row next, or dumbbell row, depending on what equipment you have, just bending over, and let's go. So you're rowing right up into your hip bone, right here, okay? Keep it going, guys. 3, 2, 1, and let's swap sides. So again, it's the same bent over position right here as the barbell row. But with these single arm ones, I find that I get a better stretch at the bottom of the movement, so I can like extend my arm a lot more and you feel it in my lap. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, back into that chest right here. One arm at a time. Let's go. See, I was talking about those arts and crafts, like, I started making friendship bracelets again. I used to make them all the time as a kid. Like, I would just spend my evenings just making them, like my mornings just making them, then I would sell them at school. And I actually made loads of money because that's something that kids buy, to be honest. And I made it, like, yeah, me and my mom, we just started our own like bracelet making business. Other side, guys, we're like, yeah, literally, we just made so much money out of it. And then we just kind of stopped because we both got really busy with other stuff. But I've been an entrepreneur since I was 10, guys. I've always been wanting to do, like, my own business. my own thing since I was really young, so it's definitely something I want to pursue in the future, have my own place. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's hit that back again, guys. One arm row right here. Bending over. And let's go. So for me to make sure I'm like bent over enough, I just look at the camera to make sure I'm still in like a frame. That's how I know. I always like training with a barrel when I do back, it just really helps with form. Alright guys, let's switch sides. Keep it going. Don't be afraid to go heavy with these, it's like we're generally stronger when we can pull than when we can push. So I'm going to be light here just for the sake of the workout, but go ahead you guys. If it's not hard, you gotta push more. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, guys. Last round of these two before we do some shoulders. Back into that chest right here. One arm at a time. To be fair, like, these resistance bands aren't all that bad. I was really, like, skeptical about using them anyway, like, before I got my weights and stuff. But you know what, like, if you really slow down the movement, other side, and like, really use time under tension, they work pretty damn well. Not gonna lie. Especially for things like chest, back. For legs, they're a bit more complicated, I think. But for upper body, they're great for getting a good upper body pump. Let's go. 3, 2, 1. All right, guys. Let go of that band. One more set right here of these bent over single arm rows. If it helps, you can like hold off of something with your other arm to support you. I usually do that in the gym when I'm working with heavier weight. It really does help. All right guys, other side right here, let's go. Really make sure you're squeezing at the top. If you don't have access to heavier weights, you can add more time and attention to these by slowing down the movement even more or holding at the top of each rep for even longer. Let's go, almost there guys, almost there. Come on, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Okay guys, so for this next part of our workout, we're gonna be focusing on our shoulders, which is like one of my favorite things to train. I say this about everything, but there's just something about training shoulders when you get a pump, it's just amazing. So we're going to be doing 5 exercises in 2 rounds. I'm going to be giving you guys set rep counts to do for these exercises that we're going to be doing every minute on the minute. So let's say the first minute we're going to do 15 reps of the first exercise. The rest time depends on how long it takes you to finish those 15 reps. So like you'll have enough time until the second minute starts again, if that makes sense. Anyways, I'm going to be timing it. All you guys have to focus on is the reps that you're doing, and then you just rest until I say it's time to go again, okay? So the first exercise we're going to be doing is a pike push-up. We're going to be doing 10 reps of that and then resting for the second minute. So just get straight into it. All right, guys, let's go right here. 10 reps. You want to bring your head as close to the ground as you can. Chin tucked in. And that's rest. Okay. It took me 30 seconds to do those, so I'm just gonna rest. And next we're just gonna be needing our light dumbbells, guys, to do our lateral raise. We're gonna do 15 reps this time. Nice, slow, and controlled. We're gonna start in about 15 seconds as the next minute starts. So here, guys, we're resting a bit longer than before because this is all shoulders. It's the same muscle group. So you need like a few seconds to recover, okay? Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Just add to the side and nice and slow back down. I think that the biggest mistake with these is that most people go way too heavy and their form breaks down and they end up using their traps way more than like their shoulders. I used to do this in the past as well. So it's really hard to count while talking, by the way. This is 10 for me. I'm just trying to, you know, stay on track right here. Let's go, a few more. 3, 2, 1, and let's relax. Okay, so that was our second exercise, 15 reps. Next, we're going to be doing a seated overhead press. So I'm going to be inserting a weight. You can do this with a broomstick and a band. It really is simple. I'm going to use my barbell for the sake of convenience. And because my barbell is quite light. So we're going to be doing 15 reps of this as well. Just make sure you keep your core nice and tight. We're going to keep our legs straight right in front of us. Starting in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's go. 15 reps right here. Again, I want you to make sure you're controlling the way down. And when you press, I want you to press straight above your head. A mistake people make with these is that they press like way too far forward, which can be like dangerous for your shoulders. So just be aware of pressing straight above your head with these. This is 9 for me. Whew, okay, let's go. 5 more. 15 reps, guys. Come on. And one last one for me. Whew. All right, guys, so here are the reps. Take your time. You don't have to do them as fast as I do or as slow as I do them. All that matters is that we're resting up until the next minute starts, okay? So next one, guys, we're gonna do around the world. So you're gonna need, again, your light dumbbells. I would go anywhere between 2 and 5 kilos for these. Starting in 3, 2, 1, let's go. So right here, it's called around the world. This is like you're kind of going around the world, like you're creating a circle shape with your dumbbells and your palms are facing forward the whole time. Okay? So we're gonna do 15 reps of these. This is 5 for me, I think. I might have done an extra one. I don't know. I'm really feeling it in my shoulders right now. These are really light. That's the thing, with shoulders you don't need that much. You can go super light and still feel it. Woo! Okay, I got 5 more right here. Couple more for me. Nice, all right. So, our last exercise is gonna be a rear delt fly. I neglect my rear delts way too much. I just hate training them, I'm gonna be honest. But we're gonna hit them in this workout today, guys. We're gonna bend over. 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Rear delt flies, we're gonna do 15. Lightweight, high reps right here. I want you to make sure you're really keeping that torso parallel to the ground. Keep it back nice and flat. These are pretty quick. I'm going to do 5 more right here. Okay. That is our first round done, guys. We're going to repeat that one more time. So that was 5 minutes. So now again, when the next minute starts, we're going to go straight into that pike push-up again. So get into downward dog position and just press. My shoulders are already really tired. I know second round is going to be a lot harder than the first, but hey, remember guys, it's all timed right here. Go at your own pace, just complete the designated amount of reps, okay? Get ready, guys. Downward dog position, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Just 10 reps of these because they're pretty freaking hard. Keep that chin tucked in. I got 2 more. I'm struggling. Woo! That was hard. That was freaking hard. Okay. So, we're going to rest again until the next minute. What was the next one again? Lateral raises. Good old lateral raises. This one's a staple for the side delt. Right here, grabbing my almond milk, my choice of dumbbell today. All right, get ready, guys. We're going to start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. 15 reps. Nice, slow, and controlled. Don't rush it. The more time under tension, the better. The more hypertrophy, the more muscles are gonna pop, okay? You want those nice capped delts. Beautiful shoulders. I've always found just like that look to be so elegant on a girl because it just makes your hourglass figure a lot more prominent. It creates that illusion. I think I've done 10. It's hard to count during these guys. 15 reps. Let's go, let's do 3 more. Nice. All right, guys, it's rest. It's For the next minute, we're gonna be doing our seated overhead press. Again, if you even have like a heavier pair of dumbbells, you can do this with dumbbells if you want. I'm using my barbell. Go ahead, use your broomstick and your band if you want, because hashtag no excuses, even if you're at home and you have minimal equipment. So let's bring those legs out nice and straight. Ready guys, 3, 2, 1, and let's go. 15 reps right here. Keeping that core nice and tight. Make sure you're pressing straight above your head right here, and I'm halfway there. I got 7 more to do. Let's go. Last 5 for me. Come on, guys, let's push. Keep it going. Woo, okay, 15. Done. 2 more exercises, guys. It's a little less than 2 minutes left to go. Then we're done with this workout, so, you know, pretty quick, but good upper body pump. We're nearly there. So our next one is around the world. My barbell keeps rolling forward. It's really annoying. All right, so let's grab our almond milks. Alpro should sponsor me, I think, because this is the second video I make with, like, their almond milk. We're doing 15 reps of these, by the way, with their almond milk in my workouts, so... And I always use their almond milk in, like, my what I eat in a day videos, so I'm just waiting for them to contact me, basically, and tell me that I'm a sponsored Alpro athlete. That would be sick, honestly, because I use so much Alpro. Like, my almond milk, hazelnut milk, soy yogurt. Their ice cream is really nice as well. Their vegan ice cream, guys, you should try it out if you haven't. It's really, really nice. Their salted caramel is mwah, so, so good. Woo! All right, I got 6 more right here. My shoulders are burning. Wow. All right, guys, let's rest for the next minute. We don't have that much longer to go. Our last exercise, then we'll be completely done with this, okay? So, right here, rear delt flies in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. Right here, remember, back nice and flat, torso parallel to the ground. Whew, I got a couple more right here. And 15 reps, completely demolished. All right, guys, nice one. That is our shoulders done. That is our entire upper body done. We're just gonna stretch really quickly. All right, guys, great job. So now we're just gonna do something that I need to do more often, and that is stretch. It's really bad. I don't stretch enough. I'm guilty. But, you know, since you guys are here doing it with me, I'm gonna be a good role model, and we're gonna stretch. So we're gonna bring one arm across the chest and nice big pull. Right here. So I just want to briefly touch on like weight training in general, especially because I feel like a lot of girls are afraid of training their upper body, or like more reluctant to go as hard on upper body days as they do on like their leg days or whatever. And honestly, guys, like, we do not have enough testosterone as girls to, you know, build as much muscle as guys, or to get as bulky as guys would. Just like lifting weights alone is really not gonna make you get that big. Like, I've been lifting pretty heavy for a while. Like, I don't wanna big myself up or anything, but, you know, my upper body is relatively stronger than most girls because I like to train it more often than most girls do. I like going heavy. It just makes me feel good about myself. I really enjoy it, and I'm not big. Like, a lot of people, if I have a t-shirt on, they won't even know that I lift. You know, sometimes when I'm wearing a tank top, you'll see that I have a bit of definition or whatever in my shoulders. Guys, just interlacing your fingers behind you here, open up that chest, and just big stretch in your chest right here. So yeah, like, take it from me, guys. I'm not huge, I'm a girl, and I lift pretty heavy. So don't be afraid, you know, go hard. It's really empowering. You'll feel really strong training the upper body. And yeah, just don't be afraid of it. Okay, guys, one last one for our lats. We're gonna go into child's pose right here. And, like, I want you to really dig the palms of your hands into the mat. And, like, just really feel that stretch in your lats. Imagine trying to reach as far forward as you can with your hands. I did 100 pull-ups yesterday, guys, so my lats are like dead. This is such a good stretch. And relax. Whew. Okay, my hair is a mess, I'm a mess. That means we worked out hard. Great job, guys, if you followed it along. Please let me know what kind of workouts you'd like to see next. I upload a new workout video every Friday for my Follow Along Friday series, so be sure to subscribe to stay tuned for those. And I also upload videos on Mondays and Wednesdays as well on topics ranging from like food, fitness, and productivity, lifestyle, those kind of things. So yeah, I hope everyone's gonna have an amazing day, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!